that the principle of using the immune system to attack cancer is an old one. Probably the best established is called stem cell transplant, the idea of taking out your immune system, getting someone else's immune system into your body to attack your leukemia. And that is a very complex and toxic therapy, but is very effective in parts of oncology. Trying to use the immune system in lung cancer has involved vaccine therapy sometimes. We've been trying, a number of different tools have been tried, and it's really been decades of immune therapy research that has not really panned out for lung cancer until suddenly we have these new class of drugs called immune checkpoint inhibitors. And these checkpoint inhibitors sort of disinhibit. The immune system is we like to think of it as the tumor and the immune system are always interacting, and the immune system is sort of sniffing out tumor cells, and the immune system learns to use the signal to tell the immune system, move on by, ignore me. You know, these are not the droids you're looking for. And so it puts on this little flag called PD-L1, and if the immune system sees this flag, it says, oh, we can ignore that, we can pass on by. And so not all tumors use this flag, maybe 20 or 30%, maybe more, use these signals to evade the immune system, evade the immune surveillance that our body's always doing. If we can block that signal, the immune system wakes up, sees the cancer cell, and can attack it and wipe it out. And so these are drugs like nivolumab, pembrolizumab, ipilimumab, which are inhibitors of these checkpoints trying to help the immune system wake up, see the cancer, and do what it's supposed to be doing. Now, it doesn't work for everyone. These drugs work, you know, maybe 20% of patients. We're still trying to figure out who they work best for. They may work a little better in folks who smoke cigarettes because it leads to more complicated genetic types of cancers, we think, versus in non-smokers' lung cancer. They're genetically more simple, and maybe the immune system isn't able to attack those as well. We're still learning, but they now become a new tool for our patients. And so we tend to give it a try often after chemotherapy. We'll try this because it's not a sure bet, but some patients can have very dramatic responses that can last a long time. And it's very rewarding to have seen some of these patients who have, you know, their cancer sort of melted away. Some patients, in fact, do after a couple years being on a drug like this are now stopping and saying, can I take a break? Maybe from here on in, my immune system will do the job and I don't need treatment. And that's an exciting idea. I would say that we haven't sorted it out yet. We now have a new set of options and a new excitement over how we can do even better and make immune therapy an option for everyone. And so an enormous number of trials are now being developed for a wide range of drugs in lung cancer, trying to make immune therapy one of our fundamental tools along with chemo and targeted therapy.